Moin, this is Timo Buske. I work for KDAB and I would like to show you how to optimize the workflow using KUESA Studio and the new Iro Materials. A typical task in a 3D project is to match a specific look or a mock-up rendering from a customer in real-time 3D. Let's take a look at the usual approach. To achieve a certain look of a 3D scene, the artist needs to follow several steps down the pipeline. To emit light and define reflections, a custom environment map is needed to match the look. Creating one of those is not trivial and requires some effort. You can render such an environment map in a 3D application like Maya or Blender. You can capture a real-world scenario with a camera and transform it into a cube map. Or you can use specialized software for that. Whatever you do, this can be a long process until you get the desired result. In a second step, the artist needs to set up and materialize the scene using that envmap inside a 3D application. Some workflows even require you to go the extra mile and build up the scene and materialize inside an additional tool, like a scene builder or a designer or what have you. Additionally, you need to export to a proprietary format. But what you'll see in the viewport of Maya and Blender can differ significantly from what you'll see in your target application or in the designer. This is because not all engines provide real what you see is what you get visuals already in that early stage of authoring inside the 3D application. This usual approach is both common and unfortunately a worst case scenario at the same time. Imagine you are not satisfied with the visual result or need to change something. The artist works on the environment map, does changes in the 3D app, if a design tool is required, re-imports and re-exports, and then builds the app to examine the final result. Even for tweaking just the property of the material, the artist would need to re-export and build or use a proprietary tool, and thus needs to have a big part of the pipeline installed, including the dev environment. So we have a long iteration loop here. In contrast to that, let's see the KUESA 3D workflow. I opened up this car model here in Blender 2.8 and I attached one of the new Iro materials. The Iro materials for various DCC applications like Maya or Blender are coming with KUESA Studio, and they are designed for two purposes. First of all, they should improve the artist's workflow significantly, so it's easier and faster to tweak the materials. And secondly, they should squeeze out the last bit of performance for your hardware. So the interesting part of the Iro materials is that you don't need to provide an environment map anymore, like a cube map or a long map. The artist does not need to do this abstract step. He rather creates a matcap or a mat swatch, and however you want to call it. And this could be a rendering of a sphere from a 3D application, could be a photo of the real world, or he just could literally paint the result of the material in Photoshop, and the Iro material will adapt its reflections to that material swatch. Let's see how this works. So as you can see here, currently I'm just using a plain gradient for the reflections. But I prepared some nicer ones, so I literally painted them in Photoshop. For example, this one is looking like a reflective sphere with a horizon in the middle. So all I need to do is just load this to the Iro material and it will adapt to the same look. This actually makes things super easy. So let's say the artist wants to add some reflective details here, or some reflecting lights at the top of the car. All he needs to do is prepare a texture in Photoshop or add some of those details to another layer and load this up. And as you can see here, the Iro material is adapting to this directly. Or let's say we want to create a metallic car paint, a silver metallic car paint. All we need to do is blur the background a bit, remain the some sharper reflections, some details, open this up, and boom, this directly looks like a silver metallic carpet here. So what you actually could do now is, if you are dealing with reflective materials like car paint, you could do actually everything in Photoshop and just load the texture to the Iro material and it will adapt. But switching back and forth between Photoshop and Blender is maybe a little annoying, so we added some parameters that makes it easy to tweak this these materials in Blender or even in KUESA later. So you can watch those changes now in the Blender viewport or up here in the material preview. So let me walk you through the material parameters. First of all, we have the factor. Thus, this allows us to stretch the normal a bit, so I can squeeze the reflections towards the center, as you can see, or I can stretch them outward to the border. What I also could do is I can do this just horizontally or just vertically, and I can make this a negative number, and without going to Photoshop I can flip the texture. Next thing is the disturb. With that I can move the reflections to the right or to the left, and especially for those car paint shaders it's super useful because you can move up and down the horizon just by changing this number. Let's move it up a bit and back to the center. So the next thing, to add a little more realism, I could bake ambient occlusion into vertex colors and multiply the final result of this shader by those vertex colors. I already baked the ambient occlusion into vertex colors, so all I need to do is just increase this number, post vertex color, and it will multiply this and we get a little more realism here. Before or after, it's like this. So if I find this is becoming a little too dark, I can bring up the reflections a bit by changing the gain value. Let's make this like, I don't know, 1.5 or so. This looks good. And so another thing I could do is to change the color of the reflections and the diffuse color. For Iro materials, we always have two colors, an inner color and an outer color, or in this case, an inner filter and an outer filter. And what this means is that the surface is divided into different parts. First of all, the parts of the surface that are facing towards you, and then the parts of the surface that are facing sidewards. And for both areas, we can apply different colors. For example, if I now apply a black color to the inner filter of the reflections, only the parts of the surface that are facing towards me are painted black, and the outer color of the reflection still remains. So I can easily create a black car from this silver reflection texture. I can do the same thing with a diffuse color. So for example, if I create an outer color for this now, let's make this red, and I copy this over to the inner filter and make this slightly darker, I can easily create a red car with the same reflections without changing the texture. And the Iro material will still adapt to the reflections you set in the material swatch. Okay, let's switch back to defaults and let's see how the Iro materials performs with some matcaps I downloaded from the web. Thank you. this look actually like a foiled car. You also could change always the filter colors. But let's leave that to white for the next one. Here we maybe need to add a little ambient occlusion to make this more realistic. Let's check out this white plastic here. Or even this outdoor scene. This is actually good to use as a clear coat. So let's reduce the inner reflection. And we might need to give the car a color. We might want to brighten the entire result up a bit. Now, as you can see, this is super easy to tweak the material and just to use some swatches you found on the web, tweak them a bit in Photoshop or paint them by yourself. Okay, let me show you one more thing. I would like to prove the what you see is what you get capabilities of the Iro materials. Let me just open up the silver car again. And the aim would be to have exactly the same visual output here in Blender or in your DCC like Maya or whatever, and later in the app you build with KUESA. So I'm going to export this now to GLTF and we'll see in a bit later in Cute Creator. So we can check in KUESA runtime. Okay, I switched to Cute Creator now. I created a small KUESA app from scratch, added the resources, the GLTF and texture exports. And I used the KUESA GLTF2 importer to import the GLTF file and switched to the camera that is coming from the GLTF file. So we have the same view and can compare the results. Okay, let's fire up the demo. And as you can see, let's compare side by side. The demo is looking exactly the same as the Blender viewport. So let's compare now how the workflow changes with KUESA. The paradigm of KUESA 3D is to optimize the workflow. To meet the artist's requirements, KUESA Studio provides a set of materials called Iro materials. Just a side note, of course, all other materials of KUESA, like the PBR material, meet the same requirements and can be used together with Iro materials in KUESA. With Iro materials though, instead of creating an env map and tweaking a material to meet the visual requirements, the artist is painting the result directly. Iro materials are fully integrated to 3D applications like Blender. This gives the artist real-time preview in the 3D viewport of the 3D app and additionally full and exact what you see is what you get. Now the artist can be sure the visual output in the 3D app is exactly the same as in the target app. When the artist changes a parameter of the material, he will get direct visual feedback in real time in the app during modeling. To examine the result, there is no need to export anymore, and there is no need for rebuilding the target app anymore. During the design process, the artist is not leaving content creation tools like Photoshop or Maya and thus does not need any dev environment installed. The iteration loop we had before is reduced to the bare minimum. In this way, KUESA 3D provides full separation of both the 3D artist's and the developer's workflow. Apart from all that, Iro materials are highly performance optimized. They are much faster to compute and thus leaves us at a lower risk when developing for low-end embedded hardware. I hope this video has been of some use to you. Thanks for watching.